I don't wanna do this, but since siya na yung nagsabi, i-turn over ko na yung envelope. The envelopes where the money was.
Comsec.
So it's 9 envelopes.
Kuha po yung envelope.
So it says Hope and the amount is there. Kasi ang sakit naman noon, ordinaryo lang akong trabahante tapos inano ka ng vice president, di ba? It's very painful.
Tanong lang po, would you also receive envelopes from Ms. Shine Paharda? Parang ikinuwento ni Yusek Mercado, envelope containing cash.
All right, Your Honor, Mr. Chair, no, I must be candid about this. I must say I did, but I didn't know because I was new in the department. I thought it was a practice of the department. I thought, you know, the very first time I encountered that matter, sir, was sometime in April of 2023. I didn't know why I was summoned to the office of ASEC Shine, and then I was given an envelope, and it was later on I found out that there was money in it, but it was not because I was a back member or whatever yet, because I was not at that time.
Magkano po pala yung laman? Magkano po laman ng envelope?
I think it was something like between 12 to 15, sir. Hindi ko na matandaan yung laman talaga.
12 to 15,000?
Very minimal amount, yes, sir.
Okay, Mr. This is in regards to Yusek Gloria Mercado regarding po do sa statement niya last hearing. According to her, nag-glance kayo sometimes in October 2023 sa Linden Suites. Do you confirm that?
Good afternoon again, Mr. Chair. Yes, sir, I confirm that. There was an activity. I think it was a training on procurement. And I'm just not quite sure about the date, but there was such an activity.
October.
Yeah. October, sir. October, yes.
Apat yata kayo. The two is in DepEd consultant, tama po?
Initially, sir, we were not just four. We were a group, including our staff. And then, but we were in one long table. And yes, with two others, me, Yusek Law, and some other staff, sir.
And during that meeting, according to Yusek Gloria Mercado, nung last hearing po, nilapitan daw siya ni ASEC Munsayak at nagsabing mag-usap-usap na lang kayo tungkol sa bidding para sa DepEd Computerization Program for 2022. According to her, that statement was made to her in your presence. Totoo po ba to?
I recall in that meeting that then ASEC Reynolds Munsayak.
Please answer.
Yes, sorry.
Please be responsive to the question.
Yes, yes. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So, totoo po. Sa pagkakaalala niya po, anong sinabi talaga, yung talagang salita ni ASEC Munsayak? Ano po ang naintindihan niyo ron?
ASEC, we were discussing, I think it was about the utilization of the funds for the procurement, sir. And it was a discussion like there was something like there is a need to be able to utilize the funds immediately. And there was some kind of a remark that, you know, something like maybe pwede naman na lang pag-usapan ng kung paano maayos, basta importante ma-utilize yung fund because the fund for the procurement was about to lapse in December of 2023. I understand this fund was 2022, sir. By the way, sir, just for purposes of background, no, I was quite new in the department. I just joined the department sometime in January of that year.
So bago lang po kayo lang.
Yes, sir.
At that time, you were already familiar with Mr. Munsayak. kilala niyo na po siya as assistant secretary?
If I recall it right, I was former HR director, sir. Yeah. So, if I recall it right, Asek Munsayak was, the appointment of Asek Munsayak was, I think, October 1st of 2023. So, he was presented as one of the new officers of the DepEd, I think, in that flag ceremony of that week. So that was the first time I saw him. And I think the very first interaction with him was on that,
so
that
nung,
lunch.
So nung marinig niyo po yung statement niya ni Asek Munsayak, what is your reaction?
I was a bit surprised, but at the same time, I was also amused, sir, because as a lawyer, I thought it was just a joke, no? the offhand remark on something like talking about it. I thought it was some kind of a joke. It was just nothing. I didn't really mind it that much.
Thank you.
Yes, sir.
So, Mr. Chair, mukhang totoo nga na may naging pahayag si Mr. Munsayak, kung saan sinabi niya kay Yusek Gloria na noong panahon na yon, as head of procuring entity, na siyang nagre-review ng dokumento ng mga bidders, pinagsabihan niya nga na ituloy na lang. At kung saan hindi tinanggap ni Yusek Gloria yung mungkahi na yon, at dapat masunod yung tamang proseso. Nakakapagtaka lang, Mr. Chair, na si Asek ay head ng procurement at malapit na kaibigan ni VP Duterte, na siya pang nagpahayag o nagpahiwatig sa isang head ng procuring entity at pati na rin sa harap ng isang back chair person. Mr. Osayas, noong huling hearing, sinabi din po ni Yusek Mercado na kayo'y isang director sa DepEd. Totoo po ba ito?
Yes, sir. I was the direct report of Yusek Glo. I was under her strand as the director of HR.
Kailan po kayo na-appoint?
I was appointed January 12, I think, and then, but I reported January 17 of 2023, Your Honor.
2023?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Ano po yung position nyo talaga?
Director 4 ho.
Hanggang ilan director po pa daw? Director 6, 7?
Hindi ho. Ang pinaka-highest ho na director is Director 4 ho. Sa
Director 4.
Yes, sir.
Ano po yung responsibility ng Director 4?
Depende ho sa assignment, Mr. Chair, or Your Honor.
Kayo po, Mr. Osias. Ano po?
Yes, sir. My responsibility is primarily on HR, Human Resource and Organizational Development. So, kami po yung in charge ng mga programs natin with respect to teachers, and then the non-teaching personnel, and then yung kami rin po ang in charge doon sa organizational effectiveness and the benefits that we can probably give our teachers, so through our offices.
Aside from that position, meron pa ho ba kayong ibang hinawakan sa DepEd?
Well, sometime November of 2023, sir, I was designated as the chair of the Back 6. No, Back 6 is the early procurement activity designated back.
Back?
Yes, sir. Bids and Awards Committee.
Sige. Na-mention niyo po na back member nung panahon na yon. Sino po ang back chair at that time?
Sir, no November, back chair ho ako. Naging back chair ho ako
naging
ng back 6. Naging
back chair kayo.
Ng back 6 ho. Yung back 6. But, yun ho.
Sige po. Hindi ba po pagka ganyang malaking government agency, especially yung DepEd, sometimes maraming mga box assigned for the procurement of particular category. In the box that you specifically belong, ano pong mga bagay yung procurement ang kailangang dumaan sa inyo? Particular.
Yes, sir. As far as I recall, ang dumaan sa akin ho ay laptops.
Laptop.
Yes, sir. Laptops for teaching, non-teaching, and yung DCP project ho.
So, kabilang po dito yung procurement relating to DepEd computerization program.
Yes,
tama
sir.
Po.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. 2024 ang original ko ho.
Noong back member kayo, Naging parte po ba kayo ng October and December 2023 bids for the DCP?
Yes, sir. I was also before the 2024, before the November designation as back chair, I was also part of the DCP 2022, which was bidded in 2023. Yes, sir.
Na-mention nyo rin po na naging back chairperson. Kailan kayo naging chairperson po ng back?
I think if I'm not mistaken, around November na po ng 2023.
November ng 2023.
Or is it December? Something November or December, sir? Kasi my memory is not really at this point.
Nare-recall nyo pa po yung mga project na dumaan sa inyo as back chair?
Yes, sir. Originally, since I was handling the back six, it is supposed to be the early procurement activity back, no? The back in charge for early procurement activity. So, kasama ho, yung nare-recall ko ho is the DCP project for 2024 ho sana. For 2024 DCP project. And laptop for teachers, laptop for non-teaching personnel. Ganun ho yung aking nare-recall na
so, up to now po, are you still working with DepEd bilang director at back chair?
Not anymore as back chair, sir, but I am still working with DepEd. Yes, but I am no longer connected with the HR. I have been reassigned under the new administration. I have been reassigned to the office of the Undersecretary for Procurement.
So, pwede kong sabihin, ranking official pa rin kayo ng DepEd?
In terms of the fact that I am an appointed director, sir, yes.
Yeah. And you play an important role kasi kayo parte ng back before, di po ba? That oversees yung DCP, yung computerization. A flagship program of the DepEd. Is that correct?
Yes, sir. As far as I am concerned at that time, yes, sir.
Tanong lang po, would you also receive envelopes from Ms. Shine Paharda? Parang ikinuwento ni Yusek Mercado, envelope containing cash.
All right. Your Honor, Mr. Chair, no? I must be candid about this. I must say I did, but I didn't know. Because I was new in the department, I thought it was a practice of the department. I thought, you know, the very first time I encountered that matter, sir, was sometime in April of 2023. I didn't know why I was summoned to the office of ASEC Shine, and then I was given an envelope. And it was later on I found out that there was money in it, but it was not because I was a back member or whatever yet, because I was not at that time.
At that last hearing, sabi ni Yusek Mercado, kung natatandaan ko, 9 envelopes yung natanggap niya, amounting to 50,000 each. Sa inyo pong pagkakaalala, hanggang kailan kayo nakatanggap na envelope? Ilan?
It started April. I think it was until September of that year.
Up to September 2023.
Yes, sir, but if I recall it right, I was only summoned about 4 times to the office.
4 times?
Yes.
Up to September 2023?
Yes, sir.
So yung last quarter po, wala na kayo natanggap?
Wala na po.
Wala. So in other words, wala na kayong envelope na natanggap ng fourth quarter ng 2023. Tama po?
Yes, sir.
Mukhang sumakto ah. Sa panahon na hindi na ginamit ng DepEd yung confidential fund for the last quarter nang pumuputok na issue ng confidential fund. Anyway, Mr. Osias, I think this was also mentioned by the BP na press conference na magkano po pala yung laman? Magkano po laman ng envelope?
I think it was something like between 12 to 15, sir. Hindi ko na ho matandaan yung laman talaga.
12 to 15,000?
Very minimal amount, yes, sir.
Okay. Mr. Osias, last week din po, after nung nandito si Yusek Mercado, meron din pong press conference si Vice President. According to the Vice President, nag-solicit daw po si Yusek Gloria from private companies using the name of the BP. Which is supposedly the reason why she was let go. Kaya siya tinanggal. So, based po sa dokumento na inilabas, ito ay patungkol sa programang DepEd Guro. Are you familiar with that project?
Yes, sir. I am familiar with the DepEd Guru project because I am supposed to be the project owner of that program, sir.
Mr. Chair, can you explain to us briefly what this project is about?
Early on, when I joined the department, about maybe a few weeks after I joined the department, and as normally done by former USEC Glo, no, she would come up with a list of things for us to do. And I recall that there were tasks given to us. I think it was after she went on a birthday trip.
By who?
There were about 40 tasks that had to be accomplished by our strand, the HR and OD strand, including the other components of that strand, sir. So thus the HR strand or the HROD strand and NAYAP and TECS, we had about 40 tasks. Out of the 40, there were about 27 that pertains to my bureau. So for HR and OD. And I recall that one of the priorities of that we were informed, no, by USEC Glo, one of the priorities that we need to deliver as a strand is some kind of a chatbot wherein the secretary can connect directly with our teachers. Meaning that the idea was for the teachers to be able to connect with her directly so that she can immediately respond to this
with the concerns. Secretary.
Yes, sir. And there were three assigned to me, and the other two were a PDIS, we call it a PDIS, an information system on all the employees of the department. And the other one was a hiring process, which will minimize the engagement of the human intervention. Also, the computations were all done by the system, something like that. So there were three. So DepEd Guru was more on the aspect of that parang immediately makakausap ni VP yung mga teacher, so they can immediately raise to her the concern. Kasi the thing there, sir, is if you use the idea there is if you use the current social media processes like Messenger, etc. No, there are about at that time there were about 888,000 plus teachers. So just imagine if a teacher comes up with a concern, and there were so many of them, matatabunan lang ho yung kanyang concern, and there is no possibility for example the VP to be able to answer the concern. So there has to be some kind of a different approach to it, some kind of technological approach wherein it will ensure that the VP is able to answer all these concerns because there are really many of our teachers.
Thank you.
So the DepEd Guru, sir, is for that purpose.
According to USEC Mercado din po, at that time, nangailangan din kayo ng external partners para sa project na to. Tama po?
Yes. Actually, as far as I recall, there was an activity wherein our strands were asked, what are your projects? What are your concerns? And we were supposed to, there is an office in DepEd that is supposed to be in charge of coordinating us, the strands or whatever, the concerns of the strands with an external partner. And they're the ones who actually are supposed to help us.
So merong office na in charge para sa pagpili ng external partners? Tama po?
Yes, sir. Yes.
So, sinasabi niyo ba walang direktang pagpili sa mga external partner? I mean, you and USEC Mercado, hindi kayo yung namili na external partners. Tama ba?
Yes, sir. I for one, am not involved in the process. I just sit there when we make a presentation on what is that guru all about.
Mr. Chair, sino ang pumipili o nag-entertain ng mga external partners para sa mga ganyang partners, especially yung DepEd Guro?
There is an office. I think it's the External Partnership Services.
External
Partnership Service or Services. I think that's the office, or is it the ICO? It's either of the two.
So, sir, parang isang department sa DepEd yun?
Yes, sir. Yes,
and
sir.
It is not under USEC Mercado?
No. It's a different office.
So, malayo. Sa pagkakaalam po ninyo, ano yung mga kailangang programang ito mula sa external partners? Why you need that external partners? Ano yung kailangan nyo sa kanila?
Well, from what I understood at that time, the need for the technological thing that the VP wanted to have, we cannot do it on our own because there is no budget for it. So we need external partners to help us make it turn it into fruition, or to make it to accomplish that program, sir. So I think that is the answer to that.
When you say external partner, kailangan nyo, hindi pera ang sinulisit nyo sa external partner, or pera yun?
If I will relate it to the DepEd Guro, it was not money that we wanted to...
Hindi
that,
pera.
That, yes, sir. It was like, because the DepEd Guro has components, no? It's like technology and other matters, no? Hardware, software. So
gamit.
Gamit, sir. I think that is the word, mga components. So, not really money, sir.
Sir, chair, kung may alam po kayo, anong gamit yun, kung alam nyo?
Okay, so if I recall this right now, the DepEd Guro will involve, for example, sir, some kind of yung ano ho dun sa, for example, sa truck, meron ho sa likod na parang lalagyan ho, parang malaking tapos may wheels, ano ba ang tawag dito, yung parang yung sa likod doon ng truck, di ba? For example, trucks na mga refrigerated trucks. Di ba yung likod doon, parang may mga closed na portions, so may gulong.
Yeah.
For example, yan, no, is one, kasi the design is, nandun sa loob noon yung mga gadgets na ilalagay, because the intention was to have three of these kinds of equipment in Luzon, Visayas, and Mindanao. So, i-deploy siya para kung mayroong conflagration, kung mayroong nangyaring masama, hindi ho, una makakausap pa rin ni VP yung mga students or concerns or whatever. And then, independently powered ho siya, component ho siya talaga ng buo. So, meron siyang laptops, meron siyang solar panel. Marami ho siyang components, sir, para ma-insure lang na kahit walang kuryente dun sa lugar, tuloy-tuloy pa rin ang magiging communication ng VP. Ganun ang pagkaintindi ko doon sa...
So, Mr. Chair, with that yung equipment na yun, kanino po mapupunta yun or saan napunta yun?
Hindi ho natuloy yung project.
So, hindi natuloy?
Hindi natuloy.
So, walang nakuha na personal na pera o gamit, equipment si USEC Mercado sa paghanap niya ng external partner para sa DepEd Guro program? Negative?
I can only speak up to the extent that I interact with USEC Law, like for example in the office. If that is the basis of that, the premise, I don't think there was any. Kasi wala naman, hindi naman ho natuloy yung project.
Sige. Sa pagkakaalam niyo po, Mr. Chair, palagay niyo ba importante itong project na to na magkaroon ng direktang komunikasyon yung halos 900,000, almost 1 million na teacher at si BP sa ilalim ng Guro program?
I can only speak, sir, from experience, no? I am a survivor of the Yolanda tragedy. It almost killed me and my family. As far as I'm concerned, there is really a need to have things like this during a conflagration, especially for purposes of our kids, no, continuing with their education despite everything that happens, no. So to my mind, it is something that we really need to have, but of course the program did not push through, so it's not something I.
So in short, ito'y naging priority project ni VP Duterte sana.
Sir, that was the information I got or we got from the USEC. Kasi siya naman ho ang nakakausap sa Exicom, hindi naman ho ako involved. Kung ano lang ho yung binababa sa amin, yun lang ho yung aming extent ng knowledge kung ano ang mga kailangan ho talaga.
Ano bang difference ng priority project kumpara do sa regular project nyo sa DepEd?
The way I understood it, sir, is that ang priority projects, these are immediate ang need. No? While the other projects, these are projects, many of the other projects have been there for the longest time pero hindi ho gumagalaw. That's why, as I was saying earlier, there were about 40 that the Strand, HROD and NAIAP and TECS had to do, no? These were the 40 identified projects that we need to do. But out of the 40, 27 are for the BHROD. And out of the 27, there were about 3 that were priority projects of the VP, including yung chatbot nga ho, or itong naging guro ang aming pinag-usapan.
Thank you po. So in short, talagang alam niya to at priority project to ni Vice President Sara Duterte. Tama po ba?
Well, I am not quite sure if the VP directly know about the project, but we present this project every time there is a Strand or Exicom or Exicom meetings, or I think that is when it is presented. But Exicom hindi na ho kasi ako kasali doon.
So, she is aware. So in short, Mr. Chairman, ang DepEd Guru Program sa katotohanan ay isang legitimate project ng DepEd na isang priority project rin ni VP Duterte, kung saan ang mga external partners ay hindi pinili ni USEC Mercado kundi ng ibang opisina sa ilalim ng DepEd. Dagdag pa rito, walang pondo o kagamitan na personal na makukuha si USEC Mercado sa programang ito. Nakakabahala lang, Mr. Chair, na isang directive ng pinuno ay siya rin gagawing rason na paikot-ikutin upang sapilitang magtanggal ng isang career government official tulad ni USEC Gloria Mercado. And that's all, Mr. Chair.